Hello and welcome to the Perot Museum of Nature and Science. My name is Elisa.
And I am Sammy.
We are some of the educators here at the museum and we love doing science experiments, so we thought we would bring one to you. I love chemistry. Chemistry is the study of just everything around us. It's the study of what makes up this world we live in. It's the study of how the things that make up this world interact with each other and why they do what they do. And so that's why it's so interesting.
That does sound pretty cool.
I know. Now we find in chemistry, what we call is matter. Matter is anything that has mass and takes up space.
Oh yeah, I've heard of matter.
Now, in order to change states of matter, we can do a couple of different things. Now, if we're talking chemistry, we have what we call physical changes and chemical changes. Chemical changes are really interesting because they do a couple of bizarre things. They'll give off light, they'll give off heat, they'll give off weird smells and gases, and it's really, really hard to go backwards. It's really hard to fix what you just did. Safety is important.
Safety first.
We're wearing gloves. We have eyewear. Of course, for us, we have to see, so that's why we're wearing our own glasses. What we have on our table, we have two flasks.
They both look like they're filled with liquids. Mm-hmm. The liquids look a little different, but they're both pretty clear.
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't look like soda or milk or anything like that.
Kind of looks like water.
Maybe water, exactly right. But they're not water. Now, in chemistry, and in fact, in most sciences, there's one very important rule, and it's the number one rule. Don't eat the science.
Don't do it.
Don't do it, because these are not water. In this flask, we have vinegar, and in this flask, we have hydrochloric acid. Now, you'll also notice on our table, we have balloons. But both of these balloons are filled with different things. Sammy's balloon has a little bit of baking soda in it. My balloon has these little tiny pellets of zinc in them. There's not a lot in there. They're not very big, but that's why chemical changes are so interesting, because you're gonna see some really cool stuff. Dexterity is also important, so be very, very, very careful. What we have to do is we have to get the balloon, ooh, thank you very much, onto the flask, get my gloves back on, and the hydrochloric acid is made of hydrogen and chlorine, and those zinc tablets, those are gonna get in there and they're gonna break up all of that hydrogen and chlorine and they're gonna send it in all different directions. And the hydrogen, have you guys ever seen the periodic table of elements? Now hydrogen is the very first square on that periodic table, but next to it, number two, on the other side, is a gas called helium. Have you heard of helium before?
I have, at birthday parties.
At birthday parties, exactly right. Helium is very lightweight. That's why it helps our birthday balloons float.
Yeah.
Hydrogen's actually a lot lighter weight than helium. But we don't use it for our birthdays for a very important reason. So now we have our hydrogen balloon. What else can we do?
I don't know. I mean, whenever I watch chemistry experiments, I always want people to blow things up. I don't know about you guys.
We have right here what we call our boomstick.
Looks very
It is a paint roller with a candle taped to it. If I were to let this balloon go right now, it would float up to the ceiling. We don't want to do that. Instead, we're going to show you why we don't use hydrogen for our birthday parties. When we light our candle, we're going to very slowly bring it, boop, right underneath our balloon, right like that. But our boomstick is nice and long, and of course, we're going to make sure we're staying safe when we get ready for it, because you're going to see some explosive science. In 3, 2, 1. Wasn't that incredible? It's very obvious why we don't use hydrogen for our birthday balloons.
I think I get it now.
It's so cool. However, it's a little hard to do this particular experiment at home.
Just like Elisa said earlier in our video, in our other flask here is not water, but vinegar, a very common acid that you all probably have at home. Inside of our balloon is our baking soda, which is a base, and it's in the form of a solid. And we're gonna contain that experiment in a closed system by using our balloon. Unlike our hydrochloric acid and zinc, our baking soda and vinegar is not gonna get hotter as the reaction continues. It's actually gonna cool down. It's gonna get colder, and we're gonna see some pretty cool things happen. So I'm gonna pour our baking soda into the flask, And you're gonna see some really similar things happening. We see bubbles. I see maybe a gas forming. Our balloon is inflating. And what's happening is a chemical change, a chemical reaction inside of our flask. So the vinegar and the baking soda, when they mix together, they actually create three new states of matter, a solid, a liquid, and a gas. So the solid is hanging out here at the bottom of our flask. It's actually not baking soda anymore. It's something called sodium acetate, or something that precipitated out of the reaction. This liquid, the clear liquid, is no longer vinegar. It's actually water. And then the gas that's filling up our balloon and staying inside of our closed system is carbon dioxide. It's the same gas that you exhale or breathe out of your lungs.
We've done some chemical changes. I think we ought to do some physical changes.
All right, you guys, we'll see you for our next video where we do some more chemical experiments. Bye.
Bye.